In August of 95, one of the U.S.'s largest CG conventions, SIGGRAPH, was held in L.A. At that time, we were not sure what the next generation RPG game should look like. So, as an experiment, we created a CG-based, game-like interactive demo to present at the show. It focused on battle scenes that were 100% real-time and polygon-based. This became the seed of Final Fantasy VII, and it was then that we decided to make this a CG-based game. When we discussed designing the field scenes as illustration or CG-based, we came up with the idea to eliminate the connection between the movies and the fields. Without using blackout at all and maintaining the quality at the same time, we would make the movie stop at one cut and make the characters move around on it. We tried to make it controllable even during movies. As a result of using a lot of motion data plus CG effects in still images, it turned out to be a mega capacity game, and therefore we had to choose the CD-ROM as our media. In other words, we became too aggressive and got ourselves into trouble. A larger developing team will not always create a better game. But when a project moves onto a scale such as this, you get to spend a lot of money and work with a highly qualified staff. We were able to use many high-end machines and work with a staff of approximately 100. And I believe this was one of the largest game development teams in history. As a result, the final game generates a tremendous amount of energy. My theory is this: if one person creates a game, it can be a racing game or anything, or 10 people create the same game, the one created by 10 people will be much richer in scope. There's a larger pool of resources to draw from, and each person is able to put passion into his role, creating a greater sense of depth. It is easy to get emotionally involved with both films and games, although in different ways. Adding certain interactive aspects to films, however, I believe that players can get further into them, even become one with the visual images. I have always emphasized visual and sound effects because rather than making my games equivalent to films, I want my games to surpass films. That is my goal. Without changing the basic gameplay, the visual and sound effects have been significantly enhanced, further drawing the player's emotions into the game. One-way RPGs force too many images and too much sound on the players, robbing them of the feel of control. In order to avoid those responses, we did extensive research during Final Fantasy V and VI on how to make the players feel interactively involved in the game while upgrading the visual and sound effects. The results of this research are reflected in Final Fantasy VII. When we were creating Final Fantasy III, my mother passed away. And ever since, I have been thinking about the theme, life. Life exists in many things. And I was curious about what would happen if I attempted to analyze life in a mathematical and logical way. Maybe this was my approach in overcoming the grief I was experiencing. This is the first time in the series that this particular theme actually appears in the game itself. See if you can spot it. The most significant difference to us was capacity. Before, we were given restrictions in capacity, so we had to create one basic model and fiddle around with it, making players believe there were variations. It was a good way to become resourceful in limited circumstances. But on the CD-ROM, that restriction was completely taken away, and we didn't have to worry about various ways of modifying one basic model. If we needed 100 models, we could create each of them from scratch. The basic concept you have when creating RPGs is to imitate the real world and create a fictional world within the game. We have followed that concept in previous versions of this series, but technically, we had to use one basic model in different ways, or use a world symbolized specifically for game use. Now it is much easier for us to achieve our original goal. We can now express more of the real world in the game. The number of simultaneous music output channels used to be 8 in the Super NES. Now it's 24. We leave 8 of them open for sound effects, so we have 16 to use for the actual music. That adds a lot of richness to the music. For example, when you hit the piano keys with both of your hands, you get 10 notes at once, and you won't be able to create that kind of a sound on Super NES. Suppose we create that piano-type sound with 10 notes, and you still have 6 notes left. This means you can fit in sounds of other instruments, and this certainly adds complexity to the game. We were able to use 2 types of CG technology in this game. One is the movie technology, where you create motion pictures using CG software and store it on CD-ROM. The other is polygon-based technology, where you create 3D objects and make them move. It is amazing to see new images being generated one after another, and all being played smoothly on the game console. You realize how powerful current technology is. Thanks to CD-ROM, cinematic expressions which were impossible in the past have become available. For example, we can now show close-ups on characters' faces, and using various camera angles, the game screen is no longer a stage-like space. However, movies can be seen in movie theaters. In order to make this thing attractive to game players, we tried hard to put playable elements in the scenarios. We made it so players will not have to follow our pace. In previous games, there were big differences between ordinary scenes and special effects scenes, and they were arranged in a certain order. The players would accept that as an established style and take for granted characters going through monotonous map scenes and then special effects being used in highlight scenes. They understood it as the grammar of the games, especially RPGs. We tried to break that understanding. For example, even in map scenes, the characters won't just move horizontally, but special, sometimes thrilling effects are added. In highlight scenes, we didn't make it too elaborate so that it will excessively stand out from the other scenes. The players will enjoy the flow of the game from the beginning through the ending, without noticing any intervals or arranged orders. In battle scenes, we use a lot of camera angles and effects, paying attention to space and 3D. Therefore, the battle scenes become the highlight scenes. The 3D effect is best shown when you use summoned beasts. These have always been the most attractive scenes in games, but we had to struggle on how to show them effectively in 2D atmospheres. Now, using 3D technology, more broad effects have been accomplished. The music in the field scenes, which is where the character walks around, has a unique flavor that no other RPGs had in the past. We intentionally eliminated the up-tempo, inspiring, rousing type of feel, meant to encourage you to embark on a journey that usual RPGs have. Instead, some parts of the music will rise melodiously, some parts will make you feel insecure, therefore creating various expressions within the same field of music. I assume players will get a different feel from it compared to previous RPGs. To tell the truth, I hope so, since this is my own experiment.
彼とは5の時から一緒にやって
I have been working with him since Final Fantasy V. When he joined Square, he told me he initially wanted to become a film director, but that he thought this would be impossible in Japan. The previous versions of Final Fantasy could be called puppet shows compared to this one. It's a real film requiring innovative effects and various camera angles. His experience studying cinematography and making his own films has contributed a lot to the making of the game. He is the director of this game.
An evil empire is sucking the life force from the planet, destroying all that's in its path. It's up to one soldier of fortune to save the world. If he succeeds, you survive. If he fails, you can always hit the reset button. Final Fantasy VII. PlayStation. Beyond the edge of reality lies a story of ultimate conquest. A story of war and friendship. A story of a love that can never be. And a hatred that always was. And now, the most anticipated epic adventure of the year will never come to a theater near you. Final Fantasy VII. PlayStation. More than 200 animators and programmers. A multi-million dollar production. Over 2 years in the making. And a cast of thousands. They said it couldn't be done in a major motion picture. They were right. Final Fantasy VII. PlayStation.